Welcome back to Backfire.
If you're like myself, a backcountry hunter, this may be the review that you're gonna like the most. Today we're looking at the Kimber 84M Hunter. 5 pounds, 8 ounces. So again, if you're a backcountry hunter like myself, this rifle catches your eye. Super light, quality's there, and when we purchased it, it was under $750. Right now, with these crazy times, we noticed that prices are going up a little bit. I know there are still some websites that have it for under $750, but again, we bought it for less than $750, so we're putting it in our review of 8 hunting rifles under $750. So this week, we have the Kimber 84M Hunter. As far as quality goes on this rifle, coming out of the box, you can already tell, like, the seams right here, they're done really well. The butt pad connected to the stock, they did a really, really good job. And overall, just by the look at it with the stainless barrel, it's a good looking rifle. At a distance, the stock may look a little cheap, but this composite stock is a lot of why this rifle is so light, but it's not. Their quality is there. It does hold a little, like if you scratch it, it will hold some scratches in there. It does have some downside to being a composite stock. But again, if you're just a backcountry hunter that wants super light, short, and accurate, this is probably the rifle for you if you're not willing to spend a lot of money. So this rifle comes in at 41.25 inches long with the action. So this thing fed really well, but there's a catch. So all these rifles that we're reviewing, we shot the same. 5 shots for accuracy. So this thing shot 0.835 and 0.842 as far as MOA at 100 yards. But after about the 5th shot, going from cold to a warm barrel or a hot barrel, this thing would really spread out. And that was one of the concerns we had pulling this rifle out of the box, was it had such a small diameter barrel on it. We didn't know how well it was gonna hold accuracy. And so when we put it to the test, we found out. 5 shots, starting from cold to hot, it would hold accuracy. But on that 6th, 7th, and 8th shot, and any shot after that, if you were just shooting them right in a row, it would go anywhere from 5 to 6 inches MOA, which is not good. But as a backcountry hunter, and just wanting a rifle that is light and shoots very accurate, I'm not too concerned about that. But if you're the guy that's gonna go out and do a lot of target shooting or shooting from the bench, you might not be very happy. Or if you're somebody that's fairly new on sighting in a rifle and you have a hard time getting it bore sighted quickly and getting it to shoot on paper, you're gonna have to for sure let it cool. Because this was happening with all 3 factory grades of ammo that we were using. And one of those 3, actually, when this would heat up, it would not feed correctly. So it would actually get jammed and not want to lock the bolt down. You could eject it and grab one of the 2 other boxes of ammo, slide it right in there, and it would shoot just fine. So keep that in mind. Sometimes each gun may or may not like the ammo that you're using. Again, all 8 of these rifles are being used with the same 3 brands of factory grade ammo. As far as the bolt release on this gun, super simple, single button, comes right out. With the trigger on this, so Kimber states that it will come anywhere from 3.5 to 4 pounds, and these are adjustable triggers. So you can adjust it down, hopefully to the poundage that you want. This particular rifle right here comes in at 3.75 pounds. On the trigger, and there's not a lot of creep in it, which is why I really actually enjoyed shooting this rifle, because the creep is very minimal, and even though it has a heavier trigger on it, it still shoots super smooth and super well. So I am very, very happy with this rifle, and this is definitely a rifle that I would go out and recommend to somebody, especially as a backcountry hunter, and purchase this rifle. And I would do so for myself because of the weight. You know, I want to get deep into that backcountry, and I'm not looking for a super long range rifle, and this rifle may be capable of shooting those long ranges. But for me, I treat every stock as I'm on an archery stock. And so even with the rifle, I'm wanting to get as close as I can without the animal knowing I'm there. And with this being so short and so light, you top this with a decent scope that may only have a 9 power on it or a 14 power, it's not going to be super heavy. You're going to be in the mid 7-pound range, which is still less or just a hair more than a bear rifle on some of these other rifles that we're reviewing. So this rifle right here with the super smooth trigger, the awesome action, easy bolt release. And my favorite thing is on this, it actually has a detachable magazine. And with that detachable magazine, it allows you, especially if you're running like a Picatinny rail on top, it allows you to load 3 rounds of ammo in here, and then you can have a 4th in the chamber. So it makes it way easier than trying to load it with that rail on top like some of these other rifles. Now, another thing I want to mention on this rifle, so it does have a really nice safety on the bolt action, but at the same time, like, this safety is pretty tough to put on safe, but really easy to flip to fire. And it's really convenient for the thumb, but again, if you don't have a really big hand, trying to switch it back or put the safety on, it takes some reaching to get that around where it's located on the bolt, and it is pretty tough, but not a big factor, just something to keep in mind with somebody with shorter hands and somebody that may not be as strong. It might be tough for them to get this rifle on safe mode, but it is super easy to switch to firing mode. This one, you can see here, the trigger guard. This is still part of the composite trigger guard, so I don't know how well the trigger guard will hold up if you're banging it or fall with it. But again, this is how they get away with making this rifle so light. Again, 5 pounds, 8 ounces. Hope you guys enjoyed this video about the Kimber 84 Hunter in a 6.5 Creedmoor. And on July 17th, we're gonna have a roundup video of all 8 rifles. And you can see what I think, Jim thinks, and Ricky thinks on these rifles and which we would take individually and maybe which might help you guys out. Like our videos, go subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave us a comment.